Hello, and I welcome all to my channel, Excelsure Academy. So in the previous video, we have talked about DNA RNA extraction and how to carry out the purification. So in this session, we are going to talk about the multiple choice questions, which basically comes for your exams like CSIR, UGC, and the other DBT, ICMR. So there are many exams for which you can prepare from these series. So before we move on to the sessions, I would like to request everyone to like, share and subscribe and keep yourself updated so whenever a video is uploaded. So let's begin our session. So the first question is, in DNA extraction, dash is included to chelate the dash ions, which is needed for enzymes to prevent the degradation of DNA. So this also we have discussed actually. So your options are chelating agent, MD2 plus ribonucleus and restol. So here what you have to remember is when we were talking about the DNA extraction, so we were always using the chelating agent as EDTA. So here you can remember that one of your answer should have the option of, it should have the option of EDTA. So we know that EDTA is the chelating agent and it chelates the dash ions needed for the enzyme. So here, what kind of enzymes we are talking about? We are talking about DNases because it will cleave the DNA. Once you start your DNA extraction and if you do not stop or prevent the enzymatic activity, what will happen? The DNA will get fragmented. It will be chopped off. So that we are talking over here about the DNases. So if we use EDTA, it is going to prevent the activity of DNases to degrade the DNA, and we also know that DNases, the cofactor is MG2+. So hence the answer is, here your answer is EDTA, MG2+, and deoxyribonucleic nucleases. So the answer is second option. Now let's move on to the next. Which of the following is not a method to remove protein contaminant from sample solution? Your options are centrifugation, shaking the solution gently with water, saturated phenol, shaking the solution gently with phenol chloroform mixture, and washing with buffer containing EDTA. So if you remember, so whenever we have to remove the protein contaminant, we have used phenol chloroform mixture because it will help in precipitating the protein out. So your protein contaminant can be removed from your DNA extraction procedure using phenol chloroform. So we know that the answers B and C is correct. And of course, you need to centrifuge so that you get the two-phase layer separation. What is not correct is washing with buffer containing EDTA. So EDTA has no role playing in removing the protein contaminant. So your answer is washing with buffer containing EDTA. Next, which of the following reagent is commonly used for bacterial cell wall lysis? Let me just move this thing. Yeah. So your options are CTAP, phenol extraction, lysozyme, and penicillin. So here we already know that bacterial cell wall has got peptidoglycan. And we have discussed previously also about that the peptidoglycan is made up of your NAM, NAG molecules. Remember? So we talked about NAM, NAG molecules. What are these? N-acetylglucosamine, N-acetylmuramic acid. So these two are linked by, they are linked by beta-1,4 linkage. Remember? So this is the site for, it is also the site for lysozyme. Site for lysozyme. So in case you want to lyse a bacterial cell, so here what you have to do is you have to add lysozyme in the mixture in order to break the bacterial cell wall. So the answer over here is the lysozyme. Yes. Next, DNA extraction from plant tissues are difficult due to presence of large amount of DNA? Of course not, because we are expecting to get a large amount of DNA. Presence of large amount of RNA along with DNA? It doesn't make sense. Presence of secondary metabolites in polysaccharide? Yes, this is very true, because because of the presence of the secondary metabolites in polysaccharides, what happens is the phenolic contents gets increased. So even if you are doing your extraction very carefully, and when you take the reading, the sometimes readings are very high. So you think that the DNA extraction or your purified DNA is high in number. So when you run the gel, instead of getting a very distinct band of the genomic DNA, you get a smear. So because of these metabolites, they actually interfere in your DNA extraction. So here the answer is presence of secondary metabolites and polysaccharides. Now, the action of Cetyl Trimethyl Ammonium Bromide, it's a mild detergent we have already discussed. In DNA extraction plant tissue is, so what does it do? So how exactly or this detergent is helping? So in this case, you have to remember is that it actually forms a complex over here. So it will form a complex as a nucleic acid and it help in the precipitation. So that becomes very easy for to do the DNA extraction. So you can read the next the other options also. So the other options are making a complex with the proteins or polysaccharides and or with the secondary metabolites. Now, which of the following reagents are used for precipitating DNA? This also we have discussed. Either you can use isopropanol or 70% chilled alcohol or ethanol. So here the answer is both A and B. This is very simple, very easy to remember too. Now, the action of EDTA in EDTA lysozyme treatment in bacterial DNA extraction is, so already we have discussed, it is the, what is the action of EDTA? It actually chelates the Mg plus ions, which is essential for maintenance of bacterial cell wall. Yes, it is true. It also inhibits degradation of DNA by cellular enzymes. It is also true because as we have discussed now, it inhibits the activity of DNases. Now, it removes the outer lipopolysaccharide layer of gram-negative bacteria. Yes, because lysozyme is actually helping you in cleaving the cell wall of the bacteria. So, the answer is all of these. So, these are very simple. So, once you are clear with your concept, it becomes very easy to go through with the MCQs. And such questions comes in your part B, where you have to remember the answers. So, it becomes very easy. So, within 10-20 seconds you can write and you can save your time. So once your concept is clear, you can answer part B very quickly. Now phenol is used in DNA extraction. This also we know because it precipitates your protein and leaves the nucleic acids in the aqueous solution. So if you remember, we have talked about over here that when we add phenol, what exactly is happening is, so you have got the appendops in which you have added your DNA sample is there. And you add phenol. So once you add phenol, what happens? It gives you, and then you centrifuge. So what happens? This becomes your aqueous layer where your DNA, RNA is there. In this, you get the protein precipitate. And bottom you get is phenol. So what will be the answer over here? To precipitate proteins and leave the nucleic acids in the aqueous solutions. Yeah. So just remember, phenol is actually precipitating the proteins and thus it is helping in the DNA and RNA extraction. Now, in cell extracts with high protein content before phenol treatment, what you can do? So chloroform is used to break polypeptides to small fragments, or SDS is used to break polypeptides small. So we know that proteases are used to break polypeptides to small fragments. So proteases are the enzymes which actually cleaves your polypeptide or the protein molecules. So here the answer is C option. Which of the following reagent is used for quantifying DNA? So it is the chloroforms, CTAB, diphenylamine or diacylglycerol chloride. So here you need to understand one thing is that, so if you are not using a nano, if you are not using the nano over here, that is, you know, to where you can add 1 microliter of the solution and you can just check the reading. So sometimes you also go for the colorimetric method. So here in this case, what happens is, so you use DNA. So it's not the chloroform and CTAB, but yes, you can talk about here diacylglycerol chloride or diphenylamine. Little bit confusing, right? But what you remember is whenever we do any colorimetric experiments, even if you don't know the answer, I'll just give you one trick is, diphenyl amine group is there, right? It always gives you some bluish color. If you remember this trick, then it will be helpful. So even if you don't know the answer, here the answer is diphenylamine. So I'll give you the story behind it. That is the principle behind it, how it is being done actually. So you have got the DNA, right? So we know that DNA has got your 2-deoxyribose, right? Now what happens when you add this diphenyl over here, it gets converted into a bluish color, bluish green color. Why? Because this bluish green color, it actually gets converted. This bluish green color is nothing but your it is actually your hydroxyl levulinic acid, aldehyde, which actually when gets in the acidic condition. So this experiment is being carried out in acidic condition. Okay. So what will happen in the acidic condition? Your deoxyribose will get converted into hydroxyl levulinic aldehyde, which on combining with diphenylamine give you bluish green color plus diphenylamine. So once you get this color, so you're going to take the absorbance at 595 nanometer. So you can make a standard over here and then run the your test samples. So let me explain you once again. So in the DNA, you have got the 2-deoxyribose, right? Now it is in the acidic condition. Now in the acidic condition, what will happen? This deoxyribose will get converted into hydroxyl levulinic aldehyde, which on reacting with diphenylamine will give you bluish green color. So this complex is the thing which you're going to read at 595 nanometer. So you have got the standard and you have got the test. So now you can compare and then quantify the amount or the concentration of DNA. Okay. So this was interesting. I hope you understood and will remember. So the answer is diphenylamine. Last question. Which of the following reagent is in correct order regarding DNA extraction? So if you see over here, the first step has to be cell lysis. So either B, C or D. Now the next comes the phenol treatment. You have to remember always this thing. Okay. Then the treatment and last is the ethanol precipitation. Okay. So from here, you will remember, you will understand that. So once you have done the cell lysis, treatment, RNase treatment, because if you're interested in DNA, you don't want RNA. So you will have RNases added so that it will chop off the RNA present and only DNA you will get. So at the end, there won't be any protein or RNA contaminations, where phenol treatment is helping you in removing the protein contamination. So that was all about the MCQs regarding DNA extractions. So as we will be uploading more videos regarding cell biology or related to CSIR syllabus, life sciences, more MCQs will be uploaded subsequently to those videos. So I would like to request all the students who are aspiring for CSIR UGC NET life sciences to go through these videos, understand the concept, try to do more multiple choice questions, because that's how the options are, that's how the online exams are going to be now. So this will also gives you practice, and you can also judge yourself like how much you're understanding and how much you are able to do the multiple choice question. And it will also help you in guiding that how much time you require in order to give the answer. Right. So here I request you to please like, subscribe and share, and any comments or suggestions are there. It is mostly appreciated and welcome. And if you can't comment, you can also write us on excelsureacademy1228@gmail.com. So thank you for watching us, and please press the bell icon so that you get all the video updates and you never miss any important topics which are related to the exams. You can also share with your friend circles and help us grow. Thank you.